I rode her off for the 10th time. What the fuck is this? The fuck are you doing here?
The fuck are you doing here?
Fucking stop!
Yeah, me too.
What the fuck, my God?
Somebody help us!
Hello?
Come on, help us!
Mental care.
Dina!
Brad! Brian?
Baby, are you okay?
Get me out of here!
Babe!
Help us!
Somebody help us!
Hey, call the police! Hey, break the glass in your case!
Get
break
me
the
out of
fucking
here.
Glass! Do it!
Stay back! Come here!
Do it!
Get me out of here!
Break it!
Manipulating your love for her and causing nothing but pain. Her fun and games pushed you both to break the law to fulfill her material needs. She is toxic. And today, all of your transgressions will be made public.
He's fucking lying, Brad!
Now you must choose who will drop out of this triangle. For within 60 seconds, one of you must die. If you wish to save her, then the saws must be pushed all the way to one side or the other, sparing her while proving for good who is indeed the alpha male.
What are you fucking staring at, you motherfucker? Do something!
Are you both strong enough to walk away from what is destroying you? Or will you fight one more time for the heart that binds? You have 60 seconds to decide. Live or die. Make your choice.
Shit isn't gonna be me!
stab you too, baby.
Do it. You gotta do it. You gotta kill him, Brad. Do it.
Stupid bitch.
Do it.
Game over.
No! No! Welcome, Vic! No!
Of horrors has been discovered at what used to be known as the Rowan Zoological Institute. The body of Umbrella Health CEO William Easton has been identified as one of the several victims of this grisly crime scene. However, we have also been informed that there may be as many as 7 survivors from this deadly event. Hopefully, the many questions the local police, the FBI, and the victim's family members will be answered by those 7 civilians lucky enough to walk away from this unprecedented.
There you go.
Hey, man.
Hey, what's up?
What do we got here?
That's Jill Tuck, Jigsaw's widow.
What does she want?
All she said was that she didn't trust the FBI.
Uh-huh.
And she didn't trust homicide.
Oh, good.
And she just wants to talk to you.
Why me?
I don't know. Only you, though.
Jeez. She looks crazier than a sack full of cats. All right. Let's get this over with. Hey. Put a cream and sugar in it.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I'm Matt Gibson, Internal Affairs. My colleague said that you wanted to speak with me.
Yes. But I need complete immunity.
Why do you want immunity, Miss Duck?
Because of what I know.
Which is what?
Do we have a deal?
You've got to give before you can receive in this house, Jill.
My husband, John, had an accomplice.
Hmm.
A person who assisted him with almost every murder.
Look, don't get me wrong. I'm all ears if you got something legit that you want to put on the table.
This person will go on killing until he's stopped. You know him, and he definitely knows you.
Is that right?
He's Detective Mark Hoffman.
You willing to sign a sworn affidavit?
Yes.
You swear to be totally open, you tell me everything, no matter how personal or private?
Yes. I'll give you evidence, whatever you want, as long as I have your protection and complete immunity. Do we have a deal?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we have a deal.
Live with Bobby Dagan, whose national tour Survive, My Story of Overcoming Jigsaw, rolls into town this weekend. Well, you're quite the national phenomenon these days, aren't you?
Well, thank you, ma'am. It's quite flattering how many people have responded to my story, and if I can help a few people along the way, then I'm pleased.
Now, you survived a trap created by the infamous Jigsaw killer, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, everyone must ask you this question. What was that like?
Life-changing. It was something I never anticipated, and quite honestly, something that should have killed me.
Tell me more. Tell me about the actual experience.
I actually have no recollection of how I got there. I just remember the feeling of waking up trapped. And I had to insert two hooks into my pectoral muscles and hoist myself up to a platform.
You put the hooks in yourself?
I did. I pretty much realized that I couldn't hold on much longer. And I had to accept the fact that I was going to die. And then I saw something. And what I saw was my life. It was a tragedy. That's even nothing. And right then, something inside me started to grow, something from the bottom of my soul. And I decided to live. I found a strength that I thought had long since expired. And I just yanked, and I yanked. And when I got to the top, I just ripped the hooks out of my chest. There was blood everywhere. And I just screamed. I just sat there and screamed. Because I hadn't just survived. I was reborn. This was my life.
Wow. Bobby Dagan, everyone. Bobby's life-changing experience comes to
the
auditorium this weekend.
Where's the big kiss?
I suggest check it out.
I don't know.
Tickets are still available.
And we're out, folks.
Something. That's not the way it's supposed to be.
No, we rehearsed it differently.
That's right, Bobby.
Yeah, they have excuses for me.
Where was the big finish, Bobby? Hmm? You tell your story, you thank your pretty wife, you bring her out for a big hug and kiss.
I just didn't want to push it, all right?
Okay, but that's the heart of the story. She was there for your whole recovery. And without the acknowledgement, without the kiss, the audience is going to have any kind of emotional connections.
I disagree. Too much emotion, and it's going to feel like pandering.
Okay, why don't you let me do the public relations and you do the legal paperwork, okay?
Okay, I get it, Suzanne, all right? It's my fault, okay?
It wasn't your fault, Bobby. You were fine. Just remember your bullet points, actually, all right?
These interviews are important, but Nina, relax.
Don't worry about them. You were great.
Yeah?
Your story's real, and people feel that. I know that you get overwhelmed at times, but we have to keep moving forward, Bobby. You were meant to do this.
I know. I know, baby.
Bobby?
Yeah?
We got the Jigsaw Survivor Group tomorrow. 30 minutes of FaceTime with other survivors.
Yeah, sounds good.
More exciting than that?
No, not much.
Wrong with killing you, Jill? I can only do it once.
Ha ha!
fucking do it! Yes! You got us into this! Get out of here! Fuck out!
Everything I see, I'm surrounded by these tiny triggers. They're everywhere, and they remind me of what I went through, what Jigsaw did to me. Yeah.
Sydney, go on. Please, you're in a safe place now. Tell me what happened next. Sydney, look at me. You made a decision. How did that make you feel?
Free. He was abusive. I tried to stop it before, but it wasn't until that moment that I really did something. It was him or me, and I chose to live. It was the best thing that ever happened to me.
That's a bunch of bullshit. He had to die for you to leave him? You want to know the best thing that happened to me? After having to cut off my own arm? Is handicapped parking at the damn mall! What the hell is a camera here for anyway?
I am simply here to illustrate the fact that a traumatic experience such as the kind that each one of us have been forced to endure can have a positive outcome. That's all.
Yeah. Like what?
A new perspective on life.
Whoa, wait.
I know. I understand that you're not at that place yet. I understand that and I respect that. But if you look around at all of these people, taking their lives for granted, if actually they all found something positive from their experience, we should never be ashamed of what we've gone through. Because we are good. And we are strong. You know what? I'd like everybody to have a look at something right here. These are my scars. Because our minds will heal. But these scars will never go away. This scar should not be a symbol of shame. It should be worn as a badge of courage. You know, earlier, I spoke of valuing your loved ones. But to be perfectly honest, it's just something that I never did prior to my ordeal. But since then, I have found someone who has truly become my rock. Joyce, if you could... Please. It's my lovely wife, Joyce.
I love you.
I love you too, baby. Bravo. To be
able to sustain such a traumatic experience and yet find the positive in that grisly act.
It's a remarkable feat indeed. Remarkable. If not a little perverse.
I'm sure I speak for everyone here when I say
how grateful we are to be part of your promotional DVD.
See you in the car, please, sir.
Of course.
Thank you. What's up?
So it's with the creepy guy with the game, someone I should know about?
No. He's been at these meetings longer than I have. He's fine.
All right. Listen, get back to the hotel, get some rest, all right?
Yeah. Everything's fine.
Great work tonight, Bobby.
Thank you.
The man.
What happened to him?
They always tell you not to smoke at the gas station.
Yeah.
This should wrap up the week for you.
Right. What's up, man?
I'm at a junkyard on 58th.
Why?
Call came in about a car crash.
Car crash, why are you there?
It's not just a car crash. It's a trap.
How many bodies?
Enough pieces to make four.
Okay, get everyone away from that crime scene until I get there.
You're an homicide, you got it?
Yeah.
All right, I'm on the way.
Yellow River, I want to play a game. The situation you find yourself in is of your own doing. You, your girlfriend, and your friends are racists. You have intimidated others based on their physical differences.
What do you think?
Why? Why this display? Why them? Why now?
You know he likes to put on a show.
Well, there's gotta be something else.
Bag the other bodies, get them back to the coroner's office right away. We need them checked for anything resembling a clue. Tattoos, piercings, skin cuttings. That man has a cavity in his tooth. I wanna know about it.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Gibson.
Yeah.
Hoffman was expecting you.
God damn. Could you look at that? Please get forensics in here. Tell them to haul ass. This needs to be dusted for prints.
Fame and notoriety based upon your story of survival. Many have aided in your cause, but few know the truth. You are a liar. You and I both know you have never been in a trap, nor have you ever been tested. Today, these lies will come full circle, and you will learn if you truly have what it takes to call yourself a survivor. The cage you find yourself in will symbolize your rebirth.
Joyce? No! Joyce! No! Please, no!
Within the next 60 minutes, you must stay upon the path of learning and traverse a series of obstacles to obtain access to your wife, who you have also deceived. If you fail to reach her before the clock runs out, she will die. Live or die, Bobby. Make your choice.
Has come forward.
As the city stays crippled in fear from the Jigsaw killings, chilling new words from the latest survivor provide a reminder of the physical and mental toll these deadly games can take.
This horrible event was happening to me, and in that moment that this thing threatened to take everything away, even the pain, I realized what I still had left to give. And I didn't want to let that go. It gave me light. That pure moment of absolute horror gave me light. And as wrong as this may seem, I'm better for enduring it. I'm stronger. And I must admit I'm grateful for it. I'm grateful it happened to me. And I wish the same for everyone like me.
Joan is but one of a growing number of citizens.
Something like that doesn't get you to change your perspective on life. I don't know what will.
Yeah. And if those people weren't so fucked up after their games, they'd make a mint selling their stories.
Thank you.
That's a real clever design. Yours or your husband's?
Everything was him.
Right, well, here's my problem. That was left for me, and your fingerprints were all over it. When you told me Hoffman had it in for you, you didn't mention that it was because you tried to kill him. There's a new game going on. Does that surprise you?
No.
No? No. You're crazy. You know that? I knew you were crazy the minute I laid eyes on you. Crazy. Okay. This is what we're gonna do. Crazy. Till I catch Mark Hoffman, this is your new home. Get comfy.
What makes you think he can't find me here?
Jill! It's a safe house. Safe house. Safe house. You get it?
Gibson. This was sent here, addressed to Jill.
Hoffman knows our location.
God damn it. God damn it! What?
We just had a small explosion here in a car at the crime scene.
Okay, is anyone hurt?
Rogers.
Rogers, you okay?
Yeah.
Get out of there, you get the bomb squad to sweep the yard.
Don't touch anything else until it's clean.
Got it.
All right.
Play it.
Hello, Gibson. Been a long time. What I want is simple. Give me Jill Tuck. You're protecting her despite the fact that she had direct knowledge throughout, which makes her complicit in every death. I'll make you a deal. Give her to me. The game stops and no one else dies. If not, everyone dies and you'll be to blame. Make your choice. The clock's ticking.
Let's get him down in the holding cell at the station. Lock it down. No one gets in without my authority.
Got it.
Stay with me. It's gonna be okay. Look at me.
Just shut the fuck up. I'm gonna get this out.
Without an H. I just want to say, I love your book so much. I just felt like I could feel everything that you went through. I feel like it changed my life.
I appreciate that, ma'am. I really do. Thank you.
Thank you.
Your name, sir?
John. With an H, without an H, doesn't matter.
John with an H this time.
You got quite an army working for you here, don't you? Must be spreading a pretty good word.
Well, we try to reach as many people as possible, you know?
You don't see anything wrong with that?
No. No, sir, I don't.
You know, history is a passion for me. Ancient Egypt, if you were speaking under oath, you were required to say, if I'm lying, take me to the quarries. That mean anything to you?
No, sir. No, sir, it doesn't.
Well, I'll tell you what it means. It means if you knowingly lied on the public record, that you're subject to a period of enslavement.
What are you implying here, sir?
I'm not implying anything.
Move along, buddy. You signed your book.
Thanks for the signature. Nice picture. But I don't need it. We've met.
Pat, Gibson says he wants you on these right away. They're from the junkyard.
That?
Yeah.
I know that from somewhere.
Hey, I've got something over here. We might know who's in the game. This was just sent to us. It was taken from a security camera downtown. The guy's name is Bobby Dagan. Familiar?
No.
He's a Jigsaw survivor who's milking it on talk shows. His wife and handlers are also missing.
choice?
Who's there? Susan. Who is that? Bobby! Bobby! Bobby, get me out of here! Bobby, help me!
Is
Bobby
out here?
Fuck no! Get this off of me, Bobby! Get
this off of me! Hello, Bobby. That feeling running through your body is fear. The fear of not knowing if you have what it takes to survive. Before you is your lawyer, who swore an oath of ethics but chose to see no evil in order to benefit herself. Once her device begins to rotate, it will pierce her eyes and mouth if you don't delay its movement for at least 30 seconds. To do this, you must step into the other machine and lift the bars to the highest position, long enough to close the circuit, slowing down her device. If you do nothing, she will whine to her death before the clock runs out. Do you have what it takes to help her? Make your choice.
Bobby, please! Bobby, please! Get me out! Get me the fuck! Ah! Ah! Oh, God!
You know this guy.
I've seen him on TV, but I don't know him.
Did your husband?
I don't know.
You sure you don't know him?
Yeah, I'm sure.
All right, then. Lock it up.
Hoffman just sent an email with an MPEG attachment. I'm just searching the IP address.
Can you find out where it came from?
It depends on how many proxy servers he filtered it through. But it was time delayed, so it'll leave fingerprints.
Play it.
Hello, Gibson. Once again, we're at a moral crossroad. I don't blame you for not giving me Jill Tuck, but you shouldn't let an old grudge cloud your judgment. Look to where you're being led. Look beyond the crossroad to the clear dawn. Do you see it?
I get it. Let's go.
Joyce?
Oh, fuck me.
There.
Why would he want us to come here?
For me to remember. This is where he saved my life. When I was in uniform, I responded to a distress call here. Back when this place was a flop house for junkies and homeless people. Assaulted me, but it shouldn't have been a death sentence.
Next time, you shoot first.
I had no choice but to report Hoffman for brutality.
You owe me.
What happened?
He got a promotion. Is what happened. And I got put on an island. A year later, I transferred to IA, busted three of his guys. He swore he'd get me back. And here we are. This place was called Crossroads Manufacturing before it closed. Look beyond the crossroads. To the clear dawn.
I'll follow you.
The man he killed was released from Clear Dawn Psychiatric Hospital when the state shut it down. That building's been abandoned for years. That's where the game is being played. All right, you get back, you stay with Jill Tucker. You don't let her out of your sight.
Still on.
MPEG came from.
Where?
A business called Pete's Auto Body on 58th Street.
The junkyard.
The location of the car trap.
Yeah, that's correct.
Okay, you guys keep moving.
Where are you going?
Get Hoffman.
Okay, let's move it. Rogers. Yeah.
What? What happened?
Gibson's got Hoffman's location.
The game isn't over.
Another body. Hold. We got a live one. Can't cross here. Let's go.
Go get your shotguns. You come follow me. Give me your gun. Hoffman! Freeze! I want you to slowly put your hands in the air. Joyce?
Bobby! Bobby! I knew you'd make it. I knew you'd find me.
I am so sorry.
I knew you could do it.
I just gotta get you.
Get me out!
Hello, Bobby. You have almost completed your rebirth. However, your final task will be your most difficult. The woman before you symbolizes your success. She is your trophy, and she has seen the good in your message, despite its dishonest beginnings.
What's he talking about?
Today, we will see if you can truly earn her love. To prove your status as a survivor, you must overcome a game that should be all too familiar. You supposedly survived it once already, so it should be easy to survive once again. Pierce the hooks through your chest muscles, and the game will begin. In order to free yourself and your life, you must hoist yourself with these chains and connect the extension cords above you before the clock expires. Both hands will be needed to complete this task, but that should be simple, for as you claim to understand, the pectoral muscles can easily support your weight. So I ask you, Bobby, when you embrace every day as if it is your last, will it be with your wife? Make your choice.
What's he talking about?
Baby, I'm so sorry. I lied. I was never in a trap.
You let me believe that.
I'm gonna make this right. You don't deserve to be there.
I'm your wife. How could you lie to me?
I know that from somewhere.
Make your choice. Clock's ticking.
Bodies, get him back to the coroner's office right away.
What is this, sir?
Kaufman tapped into the station's security system. He's been watching us the whole time.
You get every available officer back to the station.
I'm sorry, sir?
Right now!
Sir.
No!
Ha! Ha! Ha!
Gibson.
Out there.
Look.
Over the last 2 hours, it seems our entire city has been shaken to its core. In addition to the 9 police employees killed tonight, Jill Tuck, the wife of serial killer John Kramer, has been found dead. Citizens are being advised to report any activity, even remotely suspicious at this time, as blockades are being set up at major intersections within a 30-mile radius, surrounding what will be considered the largest attack on this city's police department in our history. Any citizens with information leading to the apprehension.
Congratulations, Dr. Gordon. You survived.
Without you, my work over the last few years would not have been possible. Said I have a request. Watch over Jill. And should anything happen to her, I want you to act immediately on my behalf. In return for that, I will keep no more secrets from you. I have showed you a lot of places. But there is one that will be perhaps the most meaningful to you.
Fucking do this to me! Fuck you! No!
Game over.
No!